Welcome to Nalla Narasimha Reddy Educational Societies Group of Institutions Integrated Campus. Myself, Suresh Kumar, Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering. In today's class, I'm going to explain about the problem on height of an instrument. If you observe here, the following staff readings were observed successfully with the level, the instrument having been removed after third, sixth, eighth readings. And these are the readings 2.228, 1.606, 0.988, and 1.262, 0.602, 1.982, like that. This is previously JN2H 2018 problem. See, whatever the reading, I have explained you the concept of height of the instrument, how we need to take and how we need to solve this problem. So, whatever the reading, first the staff reading you are taking, that is treated as backside. So, my first reading is backside. That is 2.28 will be the at station A. My point is 2.28. So, next point is 1.606. What? That will be the foresight. That will be the intermediate side. If you are not shifting the instrument, then it is treated as intermediate side. If you are shifting that instrument, the last reading of that instrument before shifting, then it is called foresight. So we are not shifting here. So that is why that is intermediate side. So they are told that at third the instrument is shifting. So it becomes FS. That is foresight. So at third the instrument is shifted. So the reading comes in the foresight. Next. And again after shifting, again we need to place the instrument and again we need to conduct survey. So then what happens? Then it will be the first reading of that station. So my reading is at D, that is intermediate site. Again at E, the instrument is shifted, FS. Again, that is the first reading, VS. Again F, the instrument is shifted. So, again, there is the first reading. So, that is 1.04 as a backside. Again, it is FS, the last reading of that particular instrument. After getting all these values, see, my backside, intermediate side and foresight. I think everyone understand what is the concept behind these, taking these values, backside and foresight and intermediate side. That see, whenever if you are confused to take these values, the only thing you should remember that your the first reading of that any instrument is treated as backside and last reading of the instrument before shifting, then it is treated as foresight. In between, if you are taking any readings, that is treated as intermediate site. See here, if I want to find height of the instrument, that height of the instrument, the benchmark is at the reduced level. We'll call it as benchmark or reduced level. Reduced level of benchmark is given as 200 meters. So that 200 meters, if we want to find the RL, height of the instrument, then this 200 plus that backside will use the height of the instrument. that is 202.228. Again, see here, if I want to find the RL of station B, if you want to find the RL of station B, what we need to do? The height of the instrument, this height of the instrument minus this intermediate site. Height of the instrument minus intermediate site gives the RL of the station B. So we need to calculate the RL of the station B. Next. That is the RL of the station B. Next, at RL of station C, what we need to do? We need to subtract the height of the instrument from foresight. If you subtract that value, we'll get the station C, RL of station C. If you want to find the D, station D, and if you want to height of the instrument, we'll change this here. So I need to add this 201.24 plus 209 will gives you the height of the instrument at the station C. Again, with reference to this 203.33, subtract this intermediate side, you will get the this value. What is the RL of station D? In the similar way, we need to calculate all the stations at E, RL of station E, RL of station F, RL of station G. We need to calculate all the station values, what the picture is showing. In that, the height of where the instrument is shifting, the height of the instrument, the height of the instrument is also changes. See, if you observe here, where the red mark indicates, it indicates that the instrument is shifted. So at C, at E, and at F, the instrument is shifted. So we need to, again, we need to find the height of that station, height of that instrument. That's why we have calculated the height of the instrument. After calculating the height of the instrument, so we need to check. See, this is the how we are calculated the sum of BS, sum of FS, that is 5.96 and 6.96. You subtract this FS minus BS, that is 6.196 minus 5.964 will gives you the value. And the last RL minus first RL, the difference should be same. Then it is correct. Okay, whenever you are subtracting this one, we need to check whether your foresight minus backsight is equal to the last RL minus first RL, should be same. Then only whatever the problem you are solving, that problem is correct. If you are not getting the FS minus BS is not equal to last RL minus first RL, then you have commit mistake while solving the problem in the height of the instrument. So we need to check thoroughly so that at the end of the problem, you should satisfy the FS minus BS equal to last RL minus first RL. Okay. By this, I will end my today's lecture. We'll see rise and fall method, how to calculate same problem, similar problem by using rise and fall method. Okay. Thank you.